Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome back from winter break. It's been great to reconnect with students and adults over the last little bit. I hope each of you had a restful vacation, an enjoyable time with friends and family during the holiday season. During break, my family and I drove to Ohio to celebrate Christmas with my parents, brothers and sisters-in-law, and my nieces. I love being in Ohio for Christmas, as do my kids. Time with their extended family is only made better by the anticipation of beloved holiday traditions. Being back in Ohio, especially at a nostalgic time of year, surfaces lots of memories for me, some seasonal. For example, Christmas Eve was always celebrated with my dad's family, and others simply related to growing up with my brothers. For most of my childhood, I lived in one home, 7318 Dawn Place. We moved there when I was 5, so it's really the only home I remember. The modest two-story colonial sat at the top of a cul-de-sac filled with other similar suburban homes, all built in the early 70s. Our quiet street was my playground, the perfect playing field if you didn't mind the occasional skinned knee or elbow from falling on the asphalt during football or baseball or basketball games. And although my parents moved out of that house in 2007, going back to Ohio is still home, with time there always spent reminiscing. This year, my dad unearthed boxes of photo albums inherited from his parents, containing not only pictures of me and my family from my childhood, but pictures of my grandparents and even my great-grandparents. For days, different family members would pick up a book and study pictures of my grandparents' wedding in 1946, baby pictures of my dad and his siblings, and even the pages of a family Bible from 1912 written in German, no doubt belonging to my great-great-grandparents, who immigrated in the late 1800s. Across the albums, black and white photos gave way to color photos, and we caught glimpses of my dad's high school prom and images from his time in the Navy. Eventually, there were pictures from my lifetime, vacations to Canada, school concerts, birthday parties, graduations, celebrations of my grandparents' and parents' major wedding anniversaries. It was incredible to reflect on these moments from my past with my family, surfacing moments from our history and retelling family stories. While I won't go into the details of some of those stories now, perhaps a chapel talk for another time, I began to recognize that my family's stories and shared history had a particular theme to them. We told tales that spoke to the importance of being together, supporting one another, being persistent and working hard in the face of adversity, and celebrating the good times and accomplishments. Not only did these stories recall particular moments, they held us together, and they revealed some things I have long taken for granted about my family, our values. During time at my parents' house, I saw a news report about funeral services for former U.S. Supreme Court Associate Justice Sandra Day O'Connor, the first woman to serve on the Supreme Court, and who passed away in December at age 93. Justice O'Connor's final message to her family was simple, a sure sign of her family's values. It was the one that Ava read this morning. Our purpose in life is to help others along the way. May you each try to do the same. In Merrick House, we have a simple print from graphic artist Anthony Burrell that hangs in our kitchen and speaks to my family's values. Work hard and be nice to people. I hope that as my children grow, not only do these words become absorbed as their espoused values, what they say and they do, but their shared values, creating alignment between their words and actions. While I eschew thinking of boarding schools as families, for the purpose of this chapel, there are some useful parallels, especially when it comes to creating memories, telling stories, espousing our values, and working to live up to them. From late August to early June, the people in this chapel represent a unique and specific collection of students and adults who share the Hilltop as a community. While there is continuity between the years, this particular group of individuals will never be replicated here on the Hilltop. But what is and should be common across the years is an articulated set of values that unites the St. George's community, values that create a foundation from which we work in our classrooms, on the stage and studios, on the field of competition, and in our day in residential spaces. St. George's values, who we are, what we believe, what we aim to do, and what we present to the outside world, all while learning and growing, should be enduring and create a through line for the experiences we each have here. So what are St. George's values? This question has been on my mind almost since day one. Clearly, as we gather here today in our beautiful chapel, some of our most significant values stem from our Episcopal identity. While there are religious aspects to St. George's values, I see our Episcopal identity as informing how we treat one another and how we are to be members of a broader community. The school's mission statement, a common feature of schools like ours, offers further guidance. The specific objectives of St. George's are to give its students the opportunity of developing to the fullest extent possible the particular gifts that are theirs, and to encourage them in their desire to do so. Their immediate job after leaving school is to handle successfully the demands of college. Later, it is hoped that their lives will be one of constructive service to the world and to God. Unlike many schools, however, St. George's also has a diversity vision statement, a school prayer, and an honor code. We have a school hymn, which I ask that we sing as part of today's service. The adults in chapel today know where I'm going with this talk, as I presented some of my thoughts about SG and our foundational documents this fall. In a lovely confluence of events, school values were an undercurrent of our faculty and staff in-service training yesterday, focused around the idea of belonging. And while I won't read the diversity vision statement and honor code in full, the school prayer is coming in a bit, as you know, I do want to tease out a few lines that I think provide a framework for what we try to do and be here at SG. In short, I read these lines from our foundational documents as St. George's values. These are not my words, but rather statements that are already on the school's website and listed under guiding principles. There's a line from our mission that jumps out at me, that we believe in and aim to help students, quote, develop to the fullest extent possible the particular gifts that are theirs. We do so in a community that seeks to, quote, promote genuine respect for each individual, as noted in the diversity vision statement. And as the honor code states, we are expected to be, quote, truthful in words, honorable in actions, as we engage with one another. Three simple phrases that speak to our programs, our community, and our character. These are the values we espouse, the values we teach, and the ones towards which we reach. With the clean start afforded by a new year, as well as a change of semesters on the horizon, I challenge each of us to think a bit more about these espoused values and the ways in which we align as a community and individuals in living them. I believe deeply in the importance of having a common set of values to hold us together and to define who St. George's is, how we carry out our work, what we stand for, both to the outside world and to ourselves. Extending the family metaphor just moments longer for our students, there will be a day not too far in your future when you will gather together with your SG friends just as I did with my family. You will tell and retell stories about your time here on the hilltop, sharing stories of adventures and relationships, triumphs and challenges, risks and growth, and times both good and difficult. Beyond the laughs and the memories, I hope there will be discernible echoes of SG's values in your stories and in your subsequent life's journey. Hopefully, you will go from here to lead, as the mission says, lives of constructive service to the world and to God. More than material success, awards, victories, dollars in your bank account, the name on your college sweatshirt, this is what St. George's wants for each of you. These are the values we want to see imprinted on your life and in your story. As Adam Grant wrote, you don't want to just define your success by achieving your goals. You should think about success as living your values. It's wonderful to have all of you back here again, and I wish you great success in 2024, both in achieving your goals and living out these values. Thank you.